Well, let's take a look at today's trending stories. It is time for Hot Topics. Now, of course, today, Friday, June 19th, is nationally known as Juneteenth. It commemorates the day in 1865 when Union soldiers arrived to Texas to announce the Civil War had ended and enslaved African Americans were free. That's 2 years after President Abraham Lincoln signed the Emancipation Proclamation in 1863. Now, locally, there are several events to celebrate Juneteenth. Now, we talked about a few already.
Right, yeah.
So you can head over to our website, NWA homepage, right now to find out about those local celebrations. What you're looking at is today's Google Doodle.
Love it. I love it when they do these things. Yes. In other news, the Hollywood Walk of Fame is getting some new stars. Mm-hmm. The selection panel announced its 2021 editions Thursday. Categories for the stars include motion pictures, television, and recording. Among the list of next year's recipients are Benedict Cumberbatch.
Love him.
Nick Cannon, Don Cheadle, Naomi Watts, Salt-N-Pepa, Kelly Clarkson, Missy Elliott. Posthumous honorees include Charlie Parker, Luciano Pavarotti, and August Wilson.
Great additions to the Walk of Fame.
Yes,
of
that. I love it.
All right, well, just in time for Father's Day, a film celebrating dads is coming to a streaming service near you. Our Dean Richards has what's new this weekend in home videos. Take a look.
Among the new offerings online this week is the documentary Perfect for Father's Day, Dads. Tops my weekend home video picks.
Dad, I remember you were worried that you'd never be as good a dad as your own father.
He was great. If you could be a good dad, that is a blessing that you can pass on.
You know Bryce Dallas Howard from the latest Jurassic movies, but now she's making her directorial debut in the documentary Dads. It's a thoughtful look at fatherhood, both of celebrity dads like Will Smith, her father, Ron Howard, Jimmy Fallon, and Neil Patrick Harris, but also about a half dozen non-celebrity dads doing extraordinary things with their fatherhood. For dads who feel like they don't get the same attention as mothers, this Dean's List A more than makes up for it. See it on Apple TV Plus. There's the new Nail Biter 7500, the air traffic code for plane hijacking. It stars Joseph Gordon-Levitt as a novice pilot who's forced into taking command of an in-progress flight overtaken by terrorists. There are plenty of white-knuckling action in this movie that makes me glad I haven't been on a plane in months, but it's still a Dean's List B. See it on Amazon Prime. In case you don't already have enough anxiety with politics and pandemics, there's the very legit new horror movie You Should Have Left, starring Kevin Bacon and Amanda Seyfried. They're a lovely family who have rented a summer getaway, but the house and the spirits that live there are not terribly welcoming. Maybe that's why this perfectly named film works so well. You Should Have Left. It's streaming on demand.
Our generation is going to save this planet.
There's also season two of the premiere of Netflix's The Politician, debuting this weekend following Ben Platt's privileged rich kid who wants to be president of the United States. For Pride Month, there's the season two debut of the Hulu series Love, Victor. Born from the 2018 feature film Love, Simon, this teen coming-of-age series focuses on a new kid in school coming to terms with his sexual identity. As spin-offs go, this one has a lot of heart.
Violence, brutality. It's the same story, just a different name.
And for the Juneteenth weekend, I'm recommending The Hate U Give, the moving story of a black teen who witnesses a police shooting of a close friend and the tension that follows exploding between the police and the community. Also, there's the drama Queen and Slim, about a couple out on their first date who get pulled over by the police for a minor traffic offense. But the situation escalates, resulting in tragic results, sending these two on the run in fear for their lives. In Chicago, I'm Dean Richards.